Hello, old lover.
Hello, Tom. You must be worn out.
Oh, I am, child. I am.
Here, let me take your coat and hat.
Yeah. Did a powerful lot of marching today. Longest Decoration Day parade there ever was.
Maybe you shouldn't march anymore, Tom.
Me? I'll march as long as I can stand. Marching feet, all the boys there beside me, just like it was at the Argonne. Oh, it's good to rest my bones.
That's right, Tom, rest.
All day I kept remembering the bursting shells and the noise. We were blind with smoke and death from the sound of the guns. Oh, you're kind to your old daddy, Ola. And yet, the boys kept on fighting until Jim's pa got his. The parade always brings it back. Let me check my breath.
You better, because I've got another surprise coming up.
Easy, child, easy. Well, I never was so surprised in my life.
You should have seen the expression on your face when you saw us.
I don't know what y'all was up to.
You sure had a time keeping it a secret.
Sure, I ain't been to a real surprise party since I remember when.
You know, this is the first time I've ever had the privilege to attend such a wonderful ceremony.
Yeah, the funny thing about it, Matthew, I clearly forgot this was my birthday. But I'm truly grateful for my blessing, and especially for Ola, for she is my chiefest one.
Got your breath back, Pa? Because you've got to blow out all these.
Yeah? Oh, my goodness. Come on, y'all.
My whole silver just dropped in my goodness.
The government called it all the gold, so why shouldn't we call it all the silver?
How about copper? Taking them in, too?
The first one that puts pennies in goes out.
How about you call me money, Captain?
This party in success, you won't have any stealing over here. Gotta pay double for that,
Dave. Well, madam, I wish I had been playing a juice harp.
That's your harp. Why, you have no idea how good you're helping the cause.
Go on, they don't care nothing about cause. All they care about is effect.
Say, where's the music?
Count Basie and Duke Ellington all in one.
This is a triple celebration, folks. Decoration Day, the birthday of our first eviction,
and the offering to our Mr. Flivver Johnson to take hold of the musical situation.
Ah, this is my complete entrance for this evening. Because I am the big music man around here, so I hereby accept the nomination.
And I accept the nomination.
You know you are the only ones who had the better business league.
I ain't seen one yet that could hold high account to you.
Why, Mr. Wilkins, everybody in Harlem loves you. And what's more, we got respect for him.
Sure. Yeah. Right. Everybody's pulling for you, Pa.
Well, I'm deeply honored at the confidence you're placing in me. And I give you everything that's in me. And work for the league with my whole heart, and with your cooperation, we'll put over the Better Business League and make Harlem the prosperous, progressive place it should be.
Thank you. please do.
Child, I'm just in the mood for anything.
What'll it be?
Just what you've been thinking about Flivver upstairs.
What's that?
I'll get even with you.
You heard me thinking.
I'll get even with you if it's the last thing that I do. You've got to learn your lesson and know how it feels to hide a broken heart. I'll get even with you. You'll see before I'm through. You'll come to me for sympathy. But I'll treat you as you treated me. You say you don't like publicity, but you have gone too far. It's time that folks were knowing you for what you are. So instead of being blue, I'll sit the whole night through thinking of things to say and do to hurt you too. So I'll get even with you.
So, you're going to get even with me?
That's what I said.
Why, women has been chasing me for years and years. Just smother me and they blitz me with their smile and their pain.
But they ain't had the kind of loving that I've been dishing out.
Well, they call me the chocolate-colored Romeo from East, West, North, and South.
They should come to me for information.
I read my mail.
And what I know about you, son, is going to land you straight in jail. And so you don't like publicity.
No, baby, I sure
but don't. You have gone too far. It's time that folks were knowing you for what you are. So instead of being blue, I'll sit the whole night thinking of things say and do.
Good evening, everybody. Good evening, Mr. Wilkins. My best wishes on your birthday.
My friends have congratulated me already.
Believe me, Mr. Wilkins. No one is more sincere in his good wishes to you than I am.
Good wishes? Does it wishes me good, filling my daughter's head with ideas about leaving me?
Please, Pa.
But, Mr. Wilkins, you're a big man. You can see that the work down south needs people like Ola.
And so do the work here. And I need them. And we never had no disagreements about that until she met you.
I'm sorry you feel that way, Mr. Wilkins. But give me a chance to make you change your mind.
No, I don't want your kind around here.
But, Mr. Wilkins, I love Ola.
Get out of this place.
I want to marry Ola.
You heard what Pa said. Get out.
Please, Greg.
And you may as well understand, Jim Braxton is going to marry Ola. Now get out and stay out.
Well, what about going on with the fun?
Some fun.
What you know about that? I'm just as high as I can be. What you know about that? The only drink I drink is lemon and tea. What you know about that? It took one look for me to know that I had stumbled into love, and now it's got me. There's nothing I can do about it, but oh, love walked into my flat, babe. What you know about that?
What you know about that? A bit of lemon and soda and a dash of lush. What do you know about that? A tempo, al grotto is much too much. Do you dig the situation? Well, look here. The maestro is also a connoisseur.
But I have stumbled into love, and now it's got me. What are you going to do about it?
I don't know.
love stepped into my flat, babe.
What do you know about that?
There was only some way out.
You've got to make up your mind right away, Ona.
I don't know what to do.
But it's so simple, darling. Your father wants you to marry a man whom you don't love and don't trust. But you do love and trust me, don't you?
But you're leaving out one important thing. My pa. It would break his heart.
But what about your heart if you married Braxton?
Greg, I can't. I can't.
Please, Ola, I wish you would see it my way.
Now, wouldn't pa be pleased if he knew about this?
Mind your own business, Jim.
You're my business now, honey. And I won't have you running around with this phone anymore.
Listen, Jim Braxton.
You listen. Be careful I don't push those big brains of yours down to your feet.
I wouldn't advise you to try it.
Greg, don't, please. Please, Jim.
Okay. I won't mess up your ex-boyfriend's pretty face. And I mean ex-boyfriend. Say goodbye to him and you better mean it.
Ola is taking no orders from you, Jim.
Why, you cheap chiseler.
We're getting married right away and we're going south. Come along.
I now pronounce you man and wife.
Greg and I married today on our way south. Please forgive us. We're right. Love. Ola.
Don't take it so hard, Pa. She loves Gregory. She'll be happy.
But how could she leave without a word?
I guess she thought it was useless to tell you.
You don't understand, Sister Hattie. You never had a child of your flesh shame you.
I do know. My child has shamed me.
What you mean?
Rosalia. She.
Rosalia?
I tried every way to find out. But you know she's tight-lipped. And swear she'll never tell me.
Oh, Sister Hattie, so you've got trouble too.
But I'm not turning my back on my child because she made a mistake. She needs me more now than ever.
You're a good woman, Sister Hattie. We should try to understand and help our children. And help each other.
That's right.
Maybe I can help you. And work to be done in Harlem.